Theories about our universe, in fact, being a multiverse are becoming increasingly well known. Science has moved on to such a degree that now the idea that everyone and thing could be endlessly doubled elsewhere across reality is becoming more and more accepted. We still don't know with absolute certainty that the multiverse in any form is correct, but according to some physicists, its existence should be inevitable. All of which means that some have added rules and details to the theory to blow our minds just a little bit more. This is Unveiled, and today we're answering the extraordinary question, what if humanity lives in a level 2 multiverse? Do you need the big questions answered? Are you constantly curious? Then why not subscribe to Unveiled for more clips like this one, and ring the bell for more thought-provoking content. The multiverse is a popular subject both in science and science fiction. And despite its seemingly outlandish nature, there's good reason to believe in it according to our current understanding of the laws of physics. Naturally then, some scientists take the concept of the multiverse extremely seriously, including the esteemed physicist Max Tegmark, who has gone so far as to create a multi-leveled framework of the potential multiverses that we could live in. Tegmark's model extends from a level 1 multiverse, which is generally the most accepted and considered the least controversial, through levels 2, 3, and finally 4. Each level builds onto the previous ones, allowing for even more diversity and possibilities than its predecessor. A level 1 multiverse mainly relies on two scientific assumptions that govern our current understanding of the universe, that space is infinite, and that matter is spread evenly throughout. Both assumptions appear to be supported by modern observations, which is why Tegmark's level 1 generally receives the least resistance from other scientists. The idea is that if this is the case, if space is infinite and matter is evenly spread, then all particle arrangements, no matter how unlikely, will appear somewhere in this never-ending expanse. And then they'll appear again and again and again. This reasoning then leads to a level 1 multiverse, where it's seen as inevitable for everyone to have an exact clone of themselves living somewhere else in space, in a universe just like this one. There are also many universes that are very different to this one too, remembering again that all particle arrangements are possible. But the fundamental laws of physics do at least remain the same. We took a deeper dive into level 1 in a previous video, so be sure to check that out. But for today, we're focusing on the next level, level 2. A level 2 multiverse, according to Max Tegmark, takes the idea further and envisions even more varied possible universes. In a level 1 multiverse, space stretches on infinitely and encompasses everything we know, but it is all at least still contained within the same infinite structure. A level 2 multiverse, however, proposes that our universe, our level 1 multiverse, is actually held in a bubble, and that that bubble is surrounded by countless other bubble universes, some of which are again like our own, and some of which are very different. These bubbles are then separated by vast stretches of space-time to form the new and overriding multiverse structure. The gaps between could be so vast, however, that even were you to be traveling at the speed of light, you wouldn't be speedy enough to move between them, since the space-time itself is expanding faster than even that. Moving between or communicating with universes in a level 2 multiverse, then, is theoretically even more difficult than it would be in a level 1. But nevertheless, what happens in these other unreachable bubble universes? Well, according to the theory, some could have totally different physical and fundamental characteristics. This is the main difference between level 2 and level 1. As they're not necessarily guided by the same fundamental laws, these other bubble worlds could have different dimensions, different physical constants, and even different elementary particles from those we see in our own. This creates the potential for some seriously strange universes out there, where, for example, gravity is weaker, so there's no such thing as a home star or star systems, or where atoms are unable to form altogether, and so there are no stars to speak of. For decades, scientists have puzzled over how it is that our universe, right now, appears to have hit a kind of sweet spot with the laws of physics, enabling things to be the way they are and for life to form. This idea isn't always all that popular, because it suggests that the universe works due to pure chance and coincidence, which is frustrating at best and faintly terrifying at worst. But here, a level 2 multiverse is seemingly able to provide answers. Broadly speaking, the issue of the universe having perfect values for life is called the fine-tuning problem. Regularly cited examples of it in our world include the masses of elementary particles and the density of dark energy, both of which have to be exact. If they weren't exact, then the chances are that we wouldn't be here to ponder them, because none of this universe would be possible. If our universe were the only universe in existence, the chances of these numbers being so perfect seems frankly impossible. And that's the fine-tuning problem in action. In a level 2 multiverse, however, the problem is solved because our universe is no longer alone. It's simply the one that did work while endless others didn't. Among the infinite bubbles that a level 2 multiverse proposes are, then, an untold number of bubbles that could never support life or form basic elements, which makes it easier to accept that ours, through sheer cosmic repetition, can. On the other side of the coin, it also follows that in a level 2 multiverse, there are also other bubbles that can form everything we know and more. Physically impossible life forms and structures from our point of view, but simple and expected in these other worlds. The possibilities here are essentially endless. There could be alternate bubble universes where the speed of light is significantly faster, allowing for more stars to be visible, but also ones where light doesn't move at all and darkness reigns, and so many others where hydrogen and helium weren't quite so crucial or in fact never formed. And so the universe grows differently from the outset. Or perhaps carbon isn't so abundant, and so life uses something else. Then again, life forms in another bubble could be living out their lives in two dimensions, all while trying to work out the third dimension, whilst the inhabitants of another exist in seven dimensions all at once, making them naturally able to experience things that we ourselves can barely comprehend, and yet they would think nothing of it. It's predicted that all of these different worlds in a level 2 multiverse exist inside an infinitely expanding pattern of bubbles that's forever unknowable to us. Were we to somehow observe them from afar, then we need a godlike level of power. This level of the multiverse does share similarities with other theories, though, as Tegmark himself has variously pointed out. According to the physicist Lee Smolin, for example, our expanding universe could theoretically create black holes so dense and endless that other universes could potentially form inside of those. Another theory holds that multiple universes could instead form out of an infinite series of big bangs across space. There are, of course, big differences between these ideas, but they're all linked by the suggestion of a multiverse that could hold universes which all have totally different fundamental properties, changing dimensions of time and space, a differing number of elements, or a changing makeup of atoms and matter. One question this might cause scientists to ask, then, is which conditions really are ideal for life? So far, we're the only example of life that we can see in our universe. But does that automatically mean that our universe is the best suited? Or could it be that there are other universes out there, in different multiverse bubbles, where life flourishes on every planet and not just one? Is there then a perfect universe in and amongst the countless possibilities? And is that a reassuring thought to us down here? Or could it trigger a worldwide, universe-wide, existential crisis? If nothing else, we can see that a level 2 multiverse is massive, both in terms of physical size and in terms of how much its existence could shatter more traditional universe models. But really, we're still only halfway through Tegmark's proposed multiverse roadmap, with levels 3 and 4 soon to feature in upcoming videos. So look out for those, but in the meantime, that's what would happen if humanity lived in a level 2 multiverse. What do you think? Is there anything we missed? Let us know in the comments, check out these other clips from Unveiled, and make sure you subscribe and ring the bell for our latest content.